Hello, how's it going? How are you?
How's it going?
Good, yeah, good. Although, you point the camera at her over there. See Emma there in the white jacket?
Yes.
She did that to me.
Oh, no, I was looking at that. I was like, I wonder what's on his sleeve.
Emma! That was her.
What is it? What is it?
It's lip gloss. She got it all over my thing. Yeah, yeah. So now she looks fabulous and I look like a tramp.
So was she kissing your arm, was she?
Yeah, she's making out my arm.
So you have superpowers in this film.
I do. God damn it, I never even thought of that. I do have superpowers in this film. Yeah, I can travel. Yeah, that's true. I can travel in time. That's a pretty great superpower.
That's quite an amazing feat.
I've played a superhero in a movie, technically. Yeah, that makes me happy.
Yeah, so yeah, anyway, I'm not going to go down that route. If you could go back in time and change a scene in your life, what would it be?
The message of the movie would have you believe that you should not go back in time unless you've really hurt someone else. And I try and think about the amount of people I've hurt. I've probably hurt loads of people, because everyone has. But I don't think any so grievously that I would have to change a whole bunch of stuff. So I would try and keep my life as is, because I'm trying to be a good person. Trying.
That's a good answer.
Yeah, thank you. It's a really long answer that you probably won't be able to use, but feck it, I gave it to you.
So this is Richard's last film that he's directing.
I know.
It's quite a sad thing.
It is a very sad thing.
I mean, what is it about Richard's films that really resonate with people, you think, for the last 20 years?
Well, I love the fact that in Richard's film, there's room for loveliness. There's room for joy. There's room to enjoy life. And a lot of films, that isn't the thing, because obviously drama comes out of conflict.
It's great.
There's plenty of that in Richard's films too, but he likes to give you, you know, little sprinklings of loveliness in there too, and that make your heart fill up. So I think that's what, obviously they're very funny, obviously they're very romantic, and they're the work of a generous, incredibly talented man, but yeah, I think just the fact there's room for loveliness.
And when you got the go-ahead to play the lead in this role, I mean, what was your reaction? I mean, playing the lead in a Richard Curtis film is quite a big...
Yeah, I used a few swear words, like good ones, like holy... And then I would say the swear words, I can't believe it, those sort of swear words that I won't say. I used all those sort of things, and it was an amazing day. I mean, worry someday, because you just think, I really hope I don't
it
up. But, yeah, great day. Yeah, yeah, it was amazing.
And how difficult was it to have Rachel McAdams as your love interest?
You have to put up with a lot with Rachel. You know, the ego. You know, the lack of talent and the terrible looks. All those things together make her difficult to be around, but we got through it. We worked around her, I think, and I think in the end, the film was okay. We made it work despite her. It was amazing. I think she's incredible.
Yeah. Okay, great.
Thank you very much. Really nice to meet you again.